Hello everyone, my name's Cliff and welcome back to my channel. This is Cliff's Dark Gems. And if you're new here, welcome for the first time. Today I've got a very special unboxing. The anniversary unboxing. So stay tuned. Okay everyone, so it is our wedding anniversary, our 8th wedding anniversary on the 30th of July, and I've got an early present, a care package from my family, my parents, and I'm going to show that off. My wife also went shopping today and she decided to stop off and buy some prezzies for me as well. So what we're going to talk about today is what's in the box? What's in the box? What in the box?
Hey!
What in the box?
Hey, why are you yelling like that? I'm right here.
Okay, wasn't sure where my wife was. But yeah, all's well that ends well. So, without further ado, let's just have a little interlude while I get my breath back. Okay everyone, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed that. So let me open up this package. Well, kind of been opened already, as you've seen. But yeah, decided to make it special. And let's open it up. And whew, my wife's still here. All of my wife is still here. Okay. Ooh, look what I got here. Okay, first of all, my mommy and daddy like to send me lots of little goodies. Love you guys. Thank you so much. And so I'm just going to show you some of the stuff that they, yeah. Luxury shortbread, buttered shortbread. I'm not sure if that's entirely South African. But yeah, no, not really, but yeah, okay. Some fruit pastels.
That's for me.
That's for my wife. That's for Anita. And this is for me. I love my nutty chocolate Cadbury. And then, okay, we got some books here. And I think this is from my wife. And even though I've been a little bit up and down with this author lately, what's wrong with a little bit of? Richard Layman, One Rainy Night. Now, as far as I know, this book is that it starts raining in a small town. And let me just read the inside cover here for you. The water drops like a shroud on the town of Bisbee. Warm, viscous, and unnatural, it coats the inhabitants in an unending torrent and turns them into crazy, hateful maniacs. A helpful stranger at a gas station shoves the petrol pump down on the customer's throat and squeezes a trigger. An entire cinema queue smashes its way inside the victim house to slice up the dry people inside. A loving wife hurls herself at her husband and bounces his skull on the marble floor until it sounds like the back of his head is turned into a sloppy wet meat. Okay, I'm not going to read any more. So basically, the rain that falls on his town drives everyone absolutely murderously insane. So that is One Rainy Night by Richard Layman. And as I said, I've had mixed things about him lately. He's kind of been hit or miss for me. But yeah, I'm going to give him another go. And then we got Graham Masterton, Living Death. Now, I was a bit confused at first because Graham Masterton is better known for his 70s, 80s, 90s sort of horror. He's pulp horror, and this is more like a crime thriller, but I'm still intrigued, and I'll give it a go. Okay, next up I got an author that I read last month, or I think in February, March, and I wasn't impressed. Susan Hill Dolls, no, it was Dolly, but this, The Woman in Black, has got a better reputation. And my wife said it's a brilliant movie. I haven't seen it yet. But yeah, I'm happy that I got this. I'll definitely read this sometime. Even though I'm not crazy about getting, movie covers. That's just the way it is where we live. So, biggest can't be choosers. And then, I got, and I'm very, very happy about this. I got One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. That's Jekyll. Jack Nicholson, and yeah, I've seen the movie, absolutely brilliant, and I'm yet to read the book, and that Nurse Ratched is a absolutely chilling antagonist, horrible, horrible nurse, and this is an awesome movie, so I'm hoping the book will be as good. And this was mentioned in a video I saw last night by a booktuber called The Book Thing. The Book Thing. I'm going to actually link it up here above. He's got not yet 60 subscribers. He's new to the scene. But he's an Irishman who lives in Northern Wales. A lot of his films are set out in nature. And he's very well spoken. So check him out. He's a really good booktuber. And yeah, that's One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. I'm looking forward to this. Okay, and then next up we got, more chockies. Sally Williams Homemade Turkish Delight, more chocolate. I love Turkish Delight, and I love chocolate. So there you go. And I don't know if you American folks or British folks have heard of this. So some of the stuff I show you might be a little bit, yeah. Okay, and then we got, The Awakening, or now filmed as The Awakening, The Jewel of Seven Stars by the author Dracula, Bram Stoker. Okay, I love Dracula. I did read The Lair of the White Worm, which was utter crap in my opinion. So I'm hoping that this will be a little bit better. So let's see what happens here. And this might actually be a novelization or something I can use for a particular reading event that's happening in August that I'm kind of fond of, so hoping I can use this particular book. Okay, next up we got the 13th Fontana Book of Ghost Stories, and I absolutely love this cover. This is very vintage, very beautiful, and it's got stories from authors like Dennis Wheatley, Guy de Maupassant, not sure if I'm saying it properly, and others. Okay, that's all I'm going to say there. So yeah, I love compilations. I know that there's going to be something happening in September, October, with like shorter, spooky short stories. So this will fit the bill, and that is the ghost. Okay, and then I've got another compilation of ghost stories. Well done, my wife.
Thank you.
Okay, More great ghost stories, edited by John Cunningham, including... Okay, I think this is very old. I don't know. It says here, including the Brown Lady of Raynham, Ghosts of Ancient Egypt. Maybe there's some non-fiction, not non-fiction, but kind of true ghost story, you know what I mean? Horror at Berkeley Square, and the Haunted House of Hydesville. And the authors, yeah, I don't know. Oh, let me just read the back here. It says, today we are in an age where we feel we are scientifically minded and unprejudiced by ancient folklore. Yet still we find the subject of ghosts as thrilling as ever. Is this because we feel that science and reason can never really explain what happens beyond the grave? Or is it merely that we are looking for thrills? Whatever the reason, there is no doubt about the perennial fascination of ghosts. Among the true ghost stories gathered here are Anne Boleyn, I've heard of her, headless in a spectral coach, phantom lovers, unearthly revels of a dead man's club, ghosts from India, America, and Australia. Okay, so, yeah, it's kind of interesting. I'm looking forward to it. Okay, everyone, and finally, I want to thank my mom and dad. They know how badly I've wanted this particular book. I've heard reviews all over BookTube. It's my favorite author, his latest collection, guess what it is. And I'm going to read it next month and review it. And that is Stephen King, You Like It Darker. And so thank you, mom and dad. I know you're watching. I love you. And yeah, this is very special to me. I'm very happy that I got a copy. And I might have to read Cujo again. It's one of the stories, it's kind of a sequel to Cujo. Yeah, I'm very happy I got this. I've heard only good things. So this is my next Stephen King book next month. You Like It Darker. Yeah, and I'm looking forward to sharing my thoughts with all of you. So yeah, thanks, mom and dad. Thank you. Okay, everyone. And yeah, that's the end of my video. Just to check for you all that nothing else is in the box. What's in the box? What's in the box? My wife is still hale and hearty. My Layla girl is still here. And there's nothing else. There's no blood stains. If you can see, there's nothing there. So yeah, I just want to say thank you all for watching. Have you read any of these books? Can you tell me about them? You know, can you tell me about that Graham Masterton book? Because I've never heard of it. I know it's part of a series. Let me know down in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to have conversations with you. It's fun. Yeah, and take care of yourselves. Until next time, keep those pages turning. And goodbye. Oh, and so by the way, my wife seemed busy. She cuts my hair. So next time you'll see me, I'll be looking kind of a little bit better than this. I'll be all clean cut, particularly for our anniversary. Cheers.